According to the children's health experts, a child is supposed to take 5 food groups out of the 8 that are recommended. However, only 14% of children below the age of 5 are getting the recommended dietary meals.
And since we are trying to end hunger and poverty, I think aspects of nutrition or malnutrition, if you want to put it, also come in. So we are into helping communities or supporting communities end their own hunger.
This has left a big portion of children falling sick and dying every day, and therefore there is need for immediate intervention. Karamoja, Busoga and the northern parts of the country are the most affected regions.
It is looking at stunting for children under 5. So we want to make sure that each child under 5 gets to realize their full potential.
This has made the children's health experts, nutritionists among others, to converge at Makerere University today to draw new strategies to address the challenge. Sarah Ngalonde, the head of the nutrition department at the Ministry of Health, explained that the poor feeding among pregnant mothers has also contributed to giving birth to stunted children.
We have systems in place that address these issues of malnutrition and stunting, working with the Office of the Prime Minister, who heads the nutrition aspect, with the district nutrition coordination committees, to make sure that we have nutrition in the budgets, in the plans, in the policies.
Ngalonde explained that the government has several policies and programs to support optimal nutrition. These include fortifying selected foods, breeding crops to increase nutritional value, providing supplements, and offering infant and young child feeding programs. These programs will soon be launched in Karamoja and Namutumba.
There are so many interventions that are targeting reduction of stunting, but then the stunting is not reducing as we are expecting. So we think there could be a confounding factor, and that factor is exposure to aflatoxin.
Daisy Womgasho, the head of the Hunger Project, said they are to partner with the Office of the Prime Minister to implement all the necessary projects to end stunted growth and anemia among children.
So the statistics show that there is an increase, and we attribute that to the high levels of aflatoxins in the staple foods that we are consuming.
The COVID-19 lockdown increased other forms of malnutrition in children and women, such as stunted growth, micronutrient deficiencies, overweight and obesity, as a result of poorer diets and the disruption of nutrition services. Report by Jaliet Namoya for the news.